So after you have created your video, it's going to just kind of hang here until it's processed. I'm not sure how long it takes. Probably it's different for different days or how much activity. But I'll show you one that I already made, and you can do things with the video. So I'm going to go back to a different team where I did a video yesterday, and you can see that this video is done. And so if you click on these three buttons here, you can say open in Microsoft Stream, so you can view your video and do things with it. Basically, you'll see the video beginning of it, and if you scroll down, let's suppose you want to download it, for example. So it'll say, "Hey, I want to download a video." So here you'll see another three buttons here, and you can just choose download video. I guess that's pretty much all you got to do is save it. I already downloaded it, so it already has this video in my downloads. But basically, that's how you can download the video. You can see other videos that people have made. But I think you can also share it to. I think you can take this link here, and you can open it up. I'm not sure if that's going to work for anybody out in the web. No, it looks like you have to be logged in SVSU. So as long as they're logged in, that link will work. But it's not going to work unless they have that. Have logged in. So yeah, I just download. If I want to put it on YouTube, I just download it using this button here and do the download, and then upload it to YouTube. You can edit it and you can do other things that you can figure all this out. But what you might not know is basically that you have to go to Teams and then click on the video, which will appear once it's been processed, and then you can open it in Stream and you can do what you do, kind of an Echo 360. You know how in Echo 360 you can process your videos? This is what you can do in. Sorry. You can do the same thing, similar type of a thing in Microsoft Teams if you go to the view it, open Microsoft Stream.